Helper has in his arsenal. So we'll see how this works out here. Is SA going to be playing Roy? So we're going to get another Roy on stream. Yeah, okay.
I mean, I'm really excited to see what this matchup is going to look like, but I feel like this would probably be really disadvantageous for Roy, because or DDD, because I feel like if Gordos are going to be a factor in this matchup and it's not just going to go straight up, you know, we're going to just square up right in the middle of the stage.
I mean, I'll preface it like this. Like, there's two types of DDD main. There's people who play DDD and there's everybody else.
Right.
Like, there's people that are King DDD. Atomisk is a great example of this, and I'm pretty sure Helper played a decent amount of DDD in Brawl 2. I could be wrong on that. I forgot you say it that way. Anyway.
Thanks, God. But, we were always listening for
you. So here we go. Right now, Helper's doing a really good job keeping Roy in disadvantage.
Please don't do it to him.
Oh, no!
Squeaks out of back air and gets out of that nice and clean. But, I mean, without any blood on his leaves, he goes ahead, gets that grab, putting the Helper off in a disadvantageous position right now. We'll see exactly if he's able to land any one of these. Down tilt, not going to put him in this spot to get a kill. Man.
Yeah, unfortunately, at the end of the day, you're so key DDD, and that trade is coming up all royalty right there. So really good job there from Helper, taking that first knock. And, again, King DDD has a lot of stuff, man. You know, I still feel like he's a... You know, he's still a big body. He's going to have his fair share of awful matchups. I don't think this is one that's really terrible for him, just because he's able to convert really nicely off of stuff in close. And Roy is a combo dumpster, so.
Yeah, no joke. I mean, with falling up air in general, because DDD's got such a big body, in addition to it already covering rolls pretty well, I mean, as far as a combo starter, a falling up air not only is going to cover space, it's going to hit a character like King DDD and set him up amazingly for either to get another forward air, or depending on stage positioning, a solid back air or forward air to just continue some offstage pressure.
There you go. Finally going to get the stock off right there. Not much of a gap placed between SA and Helper right there. So, you know, this is definitely within the realm of possibility for him. And that's something that's going to be huge here. The how well you play or use Gordo against King DDD makes or breaks the matchup for you. That is free damage right there.
Yeah.
It only takes about 1%. It takes exactly 1%, actually, for a move to send Gordo back towards King DDD. So let's see if SA can kind of catch on to that.
Yeah. I mean, if he can't, I mean, at this point, the one thing that he really needs to kind of watch out for is how much shield damage a lot of these Gordos are just generally doing. Because he is missing a couple of the parodies, and I mean, hate to, again, make a terrible pun, but it'll burst his bubble if he just sits there and is actually just shielding at the wrong time, because the hammer also has an additional hitbox that he can take advantage of.
Ooh. Yeah, but taking advantage of the opportunity right there, you know, catching the landing, you know, using the Gordo as a bait, and then catching him with the down smash, so really good stuff there from Helper.
Uh-oh. Actually gets an inhale, taking a straight out from his Game Boy Color days. Ooh, knocks him right out of there with a back air, not allowing him to get back on stage for free or setting up any of those Gordo setups. But, oh wow, gets him off stage, uses the jump, not able to capitalize off of it, however, lands a grab, solid forward air, goes to a wake-up situation.
Ooh, but living on the platform right now. I feel like that'll definitely benefit King DDD. DDD has these great long-lasting hitboxes and aerials, and that air dodge was very poorly timed right there, as Helper can eat a fair bit of damage for it.
And it seems like SA is really starting to take advantage of having Team King DDD in the air, definitely opting not to throw him directly in front of him for a horizontal kill. So it's working out a little bit better, but DDD definitely making back a lot more of the headway, just pushing the tide back in his favor. But Roy, again, no slouch for power. This is still very much even.
Real rap, if he got the sweet spot of that forward smash, that probably would have killed.
Oh yeah, free.
Like, King DDD is heavy, but that move is very strong.
Nice to cover his re-entry back to the stage, but ooh, Nair to forward air, going to go ahead and give him a little bit more pressure on stage. Oh my gosh, Roy's doing such a good job just measuring out with down tilt. King DDD back on stage with the Gordo, still looking a little effective, but again, a very, very volatile option. He goes off with, no, it's just reckless abandon here with that forward air, cleaning that stock up.
Yeah, great stuff there from SA. That was definitely looking in the favor of Helper right there, as that Gordo, you know, bought him some time on the ledge guard right there, and you see right there an ill-timed jump, Helper trying to, you know, maybe catch something with the forward air. Once again, going for the forward air instead of immediately, you know, dropping down a little bit lower. You know, unfortunately, not working out in his favor right there. So great awareness, and That's what you got to do in those last hit situations, man. Sometimes you just got to go for broke.
Right.
It's either you lose or I lose. Right. You know, I'm taking matters into my own hands at this point.
In for a penny, in for a pound in that situation, because that first forward air, you know, he whiffed it completely. But definitely just took the extra swing and, you know, paid dividends, as you say, Cooper. I mean, this is one of those times where he really, really couldn't avoid that chance. But coming back into it in Final Destination, I'm honestly surprised. I'm not surprised to see that the stage pick is going to completely negate platforms in this situation.
Yeah, so Battlefield and Kalos were the bans here, so I guess Helper's just going to, you know, whatever space, whatever station gives him the most usable space in the center, you know, kind of taking away the platforms from Roy, like you were saying.
Yeah, and it'll also give him the ability to take advantage of the Gordos not having a really weird trajectory, and also just keeping him on stage for a lot more usage.
Yeah, everything's going to be a lot more straightforward, and DDD on fire with that menacing grin on his face is one of the scariest things I've seen in my entire life.
Yeah, and that's one thing we hadn't seen in the previous games. It looked like Helper was just kind of like letting a lot of these Gordos go by the wayside, but Nair to forward air, but that's a big boy, man. This, we're talking about some super heavyweights.
Yeah, man, it was a size 4X. Ooh, but the unfortunate second hit up there, not connecting right there. Oh my god! Oh, there we go.
The option coverage by SA right now. Oh wow, Gordo's still active, but again, he's not really getting a chance to take advantage of SA's lack of recovery ability. I mean, even though Roy seems to be like just hunting him down off stage, he's not one of the one characters that's not so hard to get.
Nah, man, without a doubt. And Helper just having a kind of a rough go of things right now. Great use of the down tilts right now. Not getting the sweet spots, but it doesn't even matter. He's still getting the proper follow-ups out of it because King Dedede is just so big.
Yeah, I think if Helper should probably make a little bit more, look for a hard read for that forward smash.
Yeah.
But I feel like if he used a little bit more forward tilt in this situation, he'd have a little bit more of a get off me move to not allow Roy to just dash in for free.
What's crazy is that he had the forward smash read. He was just too early on it.
Correct.
He saw too far into the future. Or not far enough into the future.
Ooh, wow, double parry. Don't know if that was on purpose, but it looked really clean. I will say this. Again, Helper's just using his Gordos. Wow. Now, I didn't get a chance to capitalize it. Looked for the ledge trap roll-in since he had already covered ledge with one of those other options.
That was crazy. Roy is so fast, and he keeps such a low profile when he runs. He's able to run under the Gordo before it hit the ground with the hitbox to kill Helper.
Right.
That was absolutely amazing.
Yeah, and he used the slide tilt just so he'd be able to extend. I forget the actual.
Yeah, he used forward
turn.
Tilt, excuse me.
Yeah.
Skid canceling.
Yeah, skid canceling, that's what it is. But I mean, like I said, if Helper, if he can never get back onto his center stage, again, he's really gonna want to try to make less use of a tackle maneuver.
The best kill option in the entire game. He needed his dash attack. Clops you.
Just.
Oh, but does not matter. Forward smash connects, and that is a 2-0 from SA. His Helper will take a dip in the loser's bracket. So really good stuff there. Helper is a really, really good player. I don't know how. I know he's kind of taking a little bit of a hiatus from entering things, as we're going to take a look here at the final stocks.
Yeah, because it's not as though he was making poor spacing options. Like right here, obviously, dash.
Clops
attack.
You.
Bam! It's just like he's like the hit stick from Madden. Oh
seriously.
My god.
Yeah, again, but just such great damage out of these jab conversions. And Helper landing with a very unsafe option right there is going to get blown up for it. So.
Yeah, and it's unfortunate. But, I mean, he's doing such a good job in neutral, just trying to keep Roy out. I honestly think that if he would have switched it up between, you know, some Gordo and maybe some forward tilt, he might have been able to just kind of, like, get Roy right. in a better position.
So according to the stream chat, I believe that was our last set for